Welcome dear student, today we will see how to determine k and v value from Freundlich equation. Aim to verify Freundlich adsorption isotherm and to determine constant k and v value involved into the isotherm equation. Requirements: apparatus, reagent bottles. 5 reagent bottles are required, then beakers, burette, then pipette, then burette stand, conical flask and constant temperature bath. Then chemicals: distilled water, activated charcoal, 0.5 normal acetic acid, 0.1 normal NaOH and phenolphthalein indicator. Then adsorption is the adhesion of atoms, ions or molecules from a gas, liquid or dissolved solid to a surface, and this process creates a film of adsorbate on a surface of adsorbent, and this is known as the process of adsorption. The adsorption of gases and solute is usually described through isotherm, and this is amount of adsorbate on adsorbent as a function of its pressure or concentration at a constant temperature. So these are the molecules of adsorbate, and these molecules get adsorbed like a layer on this adsorbent, and this process is known as the adsorption. Then what exactly the difference between adsorption and absorption? So the distinct between absorption and adsorption should be clearly understood. Some of these differences are: first difference, that is adsorption, is surface phenomena, while absorption concerned with whole mass of adsorbent. Then in adsorption, a substance is only retained on a surface and does not go into a bulk or interior of the solid or a liquid. And absorption implies that substance is uniformly distributed throughout the body of solid or liquid. That's why adsorption is surface phenomenon. Then in adsorption process, the concentration of adsorbed molecule is always greater in immediate vicinity of surface than in the free phase. And absorption involves bulk penetration of molecule into structure of solid or liquid by some process of diffusion. Adsorption is a rapid process and equilibrium is attained in a short time. In absorption, the equilibrium takes slowly. Then reversible and irreversible adsorption. This adsorption is reversible when your adsorbent can be easily removed from a surface of adsorbent by a physical method. Then it is called irreversible adsorption if adsorbate cannot be removed from the surface of adsorbent. A gas is adsorbed on a surface, solid surface can be completely removed in a vacuum. It is therefore reversible adsorption. So with the help of vacuum, we can remove adsorbed gas from the solid surface, and that's why we can say that adsorption of gases on solid surface is reversible process. Example of irreversible adsorption are adsorption of oxygen on tungsten adsorbate and adsorption of carbon monoxide on tungsten surface. So these gases we cannot remove from the tungsten surface. So this type of the adsorption is irreversible adsorption. Now we'll see physiosorption. Now in physiosorption, molecules and atoms can attach to the surface in two ways. One is physiosorption, in which there is a van der Waal interaction between adsorbate and your adsorbent. For example, a dispersion or a dipole-dipole interaction. then van der Waal interaction are long range but are weak. Then energy released when particle is physiosorbed is of the same order of magnitude as the enthalpy of condensation. Such a small energy can be absorbed as the vibrations of a lattice and dissipated as a thermal motion, and a molecule bouncing across the surface will gradually lose all its energy and finally absorb to it. This is physiosorption model. This blue colored ball of your absorbent and get absorbed on the surface of this absorbent by van der Waal forces. Then chemisorption, if you observe this diagram, this violet color molecules is of your absorbent and this red and green color molecule of your adsorbent. So in this chemisorption process, molecules or atoms stick to the surface of adsorbent by forming a chemical bond, and usually this bond is covalent bond, and tend to find sites that maximize their coordination number with the substrate. So they are forming a bond with number of molecules of your substrate or adsorbent, means they are increasing their coordination number. Then distance between a surface and the closest adsorbent of atom is also typically shorter for chemisorption. A chemisorbed molecule may be torn apart at the demand of unsatisfied vacancies of the surface atom, and existence of molecular fragment on the surface as a result of chemisorption is one reason why solid surface catalyzes reaction. So this oxygen molecules are in red color, then metallic surface is having a violet purple color, and cobalt molecules represented by green color. Then Friendlich isotherm. The empirical equation for representing the isothermal variation and adsorption of quantity of gases adsorbed by unit mass of solid adsorbent with pressure is Friendlich adsorption isotherm. It is represented by equation x by m is equal to k into p raised to 1 by n or c raised to 1 by n, where x by m is adsorption of adsorbent per gram of adsorbent, which is obtained by dividing amount of adsorbent by weight of your adsorbent. P is a pressure and K and N are a constant whose values depend upon adsorbent and a gas at a particular temperature. When you take a log of this equation, your equation will become log of X by M is equal to log K plus 1 by N into log P. Then Friendlich isotherm correctly establish a relationship of adsorption with pressure at a lower value. So if you observe this graph is classified, divided into three parts. The up to this first part, and this is up to this mark second part, and from this point to onward third part. This Friendlich exactly define relationship between X by M and P into the second region, where P raised to 1 by N. In this region, third region, X by M is directly proportional to P, and into this first region X by M is directly proportional to P raised to 0, and in between 0 and 1, 1 by N value is there. Then limitation of this isotherm failed to predict adsorption capacity at a high pressure. So we can predict this relationship into the low pressure only. This is a limitation for Friendlich isotherm. When you plot this graph X by M versus P, you will get a curve shape of graph. If you want to convert it into the straight line, then you have to take a log of both the values, then you will get straight line graph. Then factors affecting on adsorption, surface area of adsorbent If more surface area is there, then more will be the adsorption. Then nature of adsorbent, heat of adsorption, then temperature, process characteristics, pressure, then thickness of adsorbed layer, and pH of medium. So these are the different factors. So factors which are affecting adsorption process. Then applications. It is used for the deodorization purpose, then decolorization purpose, then catalytic reactions, then also used into the food poisoning, then chromatography. Now we'll see actual procedure, how to conduct this experiment or how to perform this experiment. So for the these experiments, you have to prepare 0.5 normal acetic acid solution and determine its exact normality by titrating against 0.1 normal NaOH using phenolphthalein indicator. When you titrate it, you will come to know that whether it is actually 0.5 normal or not. Then you have to prepare 5 reagent bottle A, B, C and C, D and E. In these separate 5 bottle, you have to take a different volume of distilled water and acetic acid. So same volume you have to take as given into this table, into the each bottle. Then normality of this solution will be different because we are adding different amount of acetic acid in each bottle. Then normality will be different. But in first bottle, normality of your acetic acid will be same because there is no addition of distilled water. But B, C, D and E bottle will give you a different normality. Now we'll calculate what is theoretical normality of that solution. So for first solution, we require to multiply it by 0.8. Why it is so? Because among 50 ml, only 40 ml is acetic acid. So 40 divided by 50 is 0.5. Similarly, 30 divided by 50 is 0.6. So accordingly, you can calculate effective normality of each acetic acid into each bottle. Then, after addition of all these things, you have to add 1 gram of activated charcoal to each of 5 reagent bottle and keep them in a constant temperature bath for 1 hour to attain adsorption equilibrium. Then meanwhile, during heating process or when you are putting your bottles at a constant temperature, you have to shake it meanwhile. Then bottles using dry glassware, filter all mixture separately. Then titrate 10 ml of filtrate from each bottle against 0.1 normal NaOH using phenolphthalein as an indicator, and endpoint is pink color. Then determine normality of each solution. This will be your N2 value. Now we'll see how to actually perform this experiment.
Performing a practical, how to verify Fehrenbach adsorption isotherm and determine K and B values in this Fehrenbach adsorption isotherm. Now, first of all, you have to prepare this 0.1 normal acetic acid and verify its normality. So, how to confirm the normality of this acetic acid? By titrating it against the 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide. So, I have prepared this 0.5 normal acetic acid and taking 10 ml of this prepared acetic acid into the conical flask. Then I'm adding this phenolphthalein, 250 drops, and again titrate it against 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide. In front of this titration will be a conversion of this colorless solution into the light pink color solution. Now it is converted into the light pink color. Now this is the end point of the titration. Now note down this burette reading and calculate normality of this prepared acetic acid. Here I have taken 5 reagent bottle and labeled it as A, B, C, D and E. So in this reagent bottle A, I am going to add 0 ml distilled water and 50 ml acetic acid. Then in reagent bottle E, I am adding 10 ml distilled water and 40 ml acetic acid. Then reagent bottle C, I am adding 20 ml distilled water and 30 ml acetic acid. Then for the bottle D, I am adding 30 ml distilled water and 20 ml acetic acid. And for the bottle E, 40 ml distilled water and 10 ml acetic acid. Now, first of all, I am adding this distilled water. So no need to add distilled water in first bottle, it is 0 ml. And into this bottle B, I am adding 10 ml distilled water. Then for bottle B, I am adding bottle C. Likewise, I have added distilled water into the bottle E also. Now I am adding this acetic acid into each bottle. So for the first bottle, I am adding 50 ml. Bottle B, 40 ml. Then bottle C, 30 ml. Then for the bottle B, 20 ml acetic acid. I'm adding then for bottle E, 10 ml. Now in each bottle you have to add 1 gram of activated charcoal. Here I have weighted this activated charcoal 1 gram and adding into this each pot. Then shake this bottle well, and you have to maintain a constant temperature. Either it keep this bottle on a heating mantle or water bath, and then you have to titrate it. Now I am putting it into the heating mantle. So you have to put into the heating mantle and maintain a constant temperature. Here I kept a temperature 50 degrees centigrade. Okay, and during this heating process, you have to shake this reagent bottle meanwhile, occasionally. So likewise, you have to put all these 5 bottles. Same way, you have to put your bottle D and E into the heating mantle, and all bottles you have to put for the 1 hour and shake it occasionally during heating process. Okay. Then after 1 hour, you have to remove this bottle from the heating vent. Now we have finished this heating for 1 hour. Now I am removing this bottle. Now you have to cool this bottle up to room temperature. Then filter this content. And your filtrate, you have to titrate against the anode. Now these all reagent bottles are cooled. Now I am filtering it one by one. Label your beaker also as A, B, C, D, E. And then filter this content into the respective beaker. Now our filtrate A is ready to titrate. If you observe this filter paper, all your charcoal remain as it is on filter paper. So you have to take another filter paper and filtrate this B content. Now I am filtering this bottle B. Now I am filtering this bottle B content. Now our B filtrate is ready to use. Now again I am taking bottle C. Again this C bottle content is also filtered and it is ready to use. Now I am ready with my all filtered, that is A, B, C, D and E. Now I am titrating it against 0.1 normal NaOH by using phenolphthalein indicator. Now I am titrating this A content against NaOH by using phenolphthalein as an indicator. Now my colorless solution is converted into the pink color. Now we have to note down burette ready and proceed for the second filter, that is filtrate B. Now I am titrating this B filtrate. Then titrate against this functional normal anyway. Endpoint will be conversion of this colorless solution into the pink, light pink color solution. Now it is converted into the light pink color solution. Likewise, you have to titrate the C, D and E filtrate and note down the burette reading and proceed for the calculation.
Now we'll see observation and calculation part. So first observation, temperature of water bath. So it was 60 degree centigrade. Then mass of activated charcoal, that is M value. This is 1 gram. So we have added 1 gram of activated charcoal in each bottle. So you have to take 1 gram M value. Then exact normality of acetic acid. Now we have calculated effective normality, but what exactly the actual normality of that 0.5 normal acetic acid. So for this you have to use N1 V1 equation. So N1 V1 is equal to N2 V2. Okay. So this N2 and V2, that is N2 is normality of NaOH, V2 is volume of NaOH required to neutralize the 10 ml acetic acid. So V1 value is 10 ml. Now we are going to calculate N1 value. So this N1 value is 0.48 normal. So actual normality, exact normality of our prepared acetic acid is 0.48. So that's why you have to divide this normality, that is Na value, sorry, multiply by this N1 value or Na value, the respective factor, and then you will get effective normality. Then N1 is initial normality of acetic acid in gram equivalent. Then C is equal to N2 is equal to equilibrium normality of in gram equivalent per liter. Means after completion of experiment, you are titrating this acetic acid. So this will be the value of your N2. Then N1 minus N2, that is gram equivalent of acetic acid adsorbed per liter of solution. Then bottle A, normality of acetic acid N1 V1 is equal to N2 V2. So by using this equation, we can calculate exact normality of acetic acid. 37 N1 V1 is value of your NaOH, while N2 V2 values of your acetic acid. So we have taken 10 ml acetic acid, N2 is we are going to calculate. So by rearranging this equation, we'll get value 0.37. Similarly, you have to calculate for bottle B. Then it is 0.20 normal. Then for bottle C, it is obtained 0.153 because our burette reading was 15.2. Then for bottle D, it is 0.1 normal. And for bottle E, it is 0.05 normal. So you have to put this. You have to put these values in this observation table. First column, bottle, N1 effective normality we have calculated. Then N2 is actual normality. N2 is a normality of acetic acid after adsorption process. So we have calculated this value. I just put this value in this second column. Then what you have to do? You have to take a log C value. Now what is C? That is N2 value. You have to take its log, then you will get log C. Then you have to calculate W, that is 3 into N1 minus N2. Then these are values for N1 minus N2. Then next column is W by M. This will be your small W value, where M value is 1, so your value will remain as it is, that is small W. Here capital W, that is 3 into N1 minus N2, and then divided by small M, that is amount of charcoal you have taken. So we have taken 1 gram, that's why same value will be there into the two column. Then you have to take log of this value. This will be your log of W by M. Okay. Then what you have to do? You have to plot a graph. Which graph you require to plot that log W upon M versus log C. Then after plotting a graph, you will get equation. So that equation is y is equal to 1.0119x minus 0.3178. So this is equation in the form of y is equal to mx plus c, where m is slope. Okay, then m value is here 1.0119. Okay, this is a slope value. Now we are using this slope value. Because the B value into this Freundlich equation is 1 by M, that is slope value. So 1 upon 1.0119, so final value will be 0.98. Then our equation is log of X by M is equal to 1 upon slope into log C plus log K. So we have our B value with us. Now we are calculating K value in this Freundlich equation. Now we are putting this B value in this equation, and you have to consider any one point from the graph. Here I have considered one point from the graph, and the respective values of log X by M and log C of that point is minus 0.4 and minus 0.82. Then you have to put this value in this equation and calculate your log K value. Now after calculation, my log K value is 0.4046. When I took anti-log of this, then I got value of K, and that value is 2.53. So in this way we can calculate B as well as K value, which are the constant values from the Freundlich equation. We have calculated here by using graph. So result, the constant of Freundlich adsorption isotherm were found to be K is equal to 0.98 and B is equal to, K is equal to 2.53 and B is equal to 0.98. Now we'll see a question bank. So what is adsorption? Adsorption is the phenomena in which molecules of a substance are attracted and adhered to the surface of a solid or liquid, and adsorption is the surface phenomena. Adsorption is exothermic reaction. Released heat is called heat of adsorption. Then what is absorption? When a substance is uniformly distributed throughout bulk of another substance, this shows that absorption has taken place and it occurs at the uniform rate throughout the body of material. So this is difference between adsorption and absorption. The next question, what is physiosorption? So physiosorption is related with weak van der Waals forces exist between adsorbate and adsorbent, and that type of the adsorption is known as physiosorption. Then example, charcoal adsorbs gases, charcoal adsorbs acetic acid, silica gel adsorbs moisture. So these are the example of physiosorption. Then what is chemisorption? Chemical adsorption or chemisorption is a phenomenon of adsorption in which chemical forces will exist between adsorbate and adsorbent, and these forces may be ionic or covalent. Means there is a formation of ionic or covalent bond in between your adsorbate and adsorbent, and this process is known as the chemisorption. Example, adsorption of hydrogen gas, nitrogen gas, oxygen gas on Ni, then platinum. Then what is catalyst? This catalysis is a phenomena by which rate of reaction is altered by the presence of substance which itself remain unchanged chemically in the process, and the substance altering the rate of reaction as a catalyst. Sometimes this adsorption process or solid is used as a catalyst. Then next question, give mathematical equation relating the pressure and extent of adsorption on gases on the metal. So adsorption isotherm will explain a variation magnitude of adsorption with pressure at a given temperature, and this is obtained by a plotting of adsorption versus pressure. You will get these type of the graphs as shown below. A rate of adsorption increases with pressure. If you observe this first graph, as we are increasing pressure, adsorption process is also increases. After reaching a limiting value, adsorption process, when your adsorbent gets saturated with adsorbate, then process of adsorption remain constant, and that pressure is called equilibrium pressure. The pressure at which your adsorption process is showing constant reading, then this pressure is known as the equilibrium pressure. At that stage, rate of adsorption and rate of desorption are same. Then equation for this relationship between x by m and k is x by m and p is x by m is equal to k into p raised to 1 by n. So this is equation for relationship of x by m and p. So this is all about Friendly adsorption isotherm. Thank you.